The following is a Shaw TV sports presentation.
From the Hank Reese Soccer Center in Saskatoon, it's the Conexus Provincial Volleyball Championships on Shaw. Hello, everyone. I'm Heath Mulligan along with Emily Humbert, and it's the 14U Women's Championship Final. Waka's Warriors and the Royal Elite out of the Regina QCVC Club will face off for the gold medal. The Regina Club, no surprise, they're in the final.
Absolutely. They're the number two seed coming in, so they were kind of expected to be in the final. Meanwhile, Waka, though, is sort of the Cinderella team of this tournament. They really came from the 11th seed, and they've made their way up. Look for Waka to be a really good defensive, scrappy team, and they could give QCVC a run for their money in this game.
They've got a smaller roster, the Waka team. Does that affect them at this stage of a tournament like this?
You know, it may, but you know, the girls are probably so excited just to be in the final. They're ready to go, I bet.
Adrenaline. Waka and the Regina QCVC Royal Elite will play for gold. It's the 14U Women's Final on Shaw. All right, we are just about set to go. The team's getting their pep talks from their coaches. There's a look at the Waka Warriors. Lyle Gardner is the head coach of the club from Waka, and Regina's QCVC Royal Elite, head coached by Don Morrison. They've got their starters all lined up and ready to go, and it looks like Regina is ready to get this thing going. Waka, just some finishing words from Coach Gardner. And once he said what he has to say, it's in the hand of the kids. Scared me a little bit, Emily. They're pretty serious over there.
They've got pretty good cheers in Waka.
So the format for our 14U Championship Provincial Final will be best of three. Two 25s and one 15 if necessary. In any of the three games, the team that wins must win by at least 2 points, so we'll keep our eyes on that. Otherwise, relax and enjoy some great volleyball. I had the pleasure of watching the 13U Provincial Final here, Emily, and I was pretty impressed. They've got a cool rule with the triple ball thing where there's not very many serves, but out of that, you get a lot of long rallies. It was great to watch, but now I'm ready to take it up one notch.
Absolutely.
We've got everything we need except a game ball. The kids are all on the court, ready to go. The referees are blowing their whistles saying, bring it. And we got no bullets in the gun. I'm not sure where the game ball has disappeared to, but apparently the game ball and the practice balls are different balls, so we're gonna wait. We got somebody running an errand now. See, if you didn't have the headset on here, they would have said, hey, Emily, go find the volleyballs.
They just might have.
We're getting you out of work already.
Yes, I appreciate that. Thank you.
Very welcome. So where are you playing and where are you at in your volleyball career? Still at U of S?
I am still at U of S, yeah. I just finished off my third year. I am a middle blocker on the Husky volleyball team, and I am heading into my fourth year of eligibility next year, also my fourth year of kinesiology. And I look forward to completing my degree and finishing out my 5 years as a Husky athlete.
Nice. Yeah. How was the season?
Well, we had some ups and downs this season. Lots of good things, lots of stuff we need to work on, but we're looking forward to getting into the weight room this off season and on the court and getting better.
Were you awesome yourself, though? You did your thing?
No. There's some good ones, some bad ones.
We did it. We found something to talk about until the ball arrived. And here we go. Kristen Galloway opens it up with an ace. Right away. Regina on the scoreboard. Galloway, a lefty, trying to drop another one. Good hard serve, and it's going to go out of bounds very quickly. 2-point advantage. Regina's Queen City Volleyball Club Royal Elite. Galloway, that's another solid serve, and it's played high. Good pass there, though, and there's the kill for the single point. Waka fights back with a good attack. And they'll take the serve and the point. Kennedy Oleksyn. Jump serve. And a hard one. Trying to fight it off, though. Little tip. Good fill there to get that one off the floor. Dana Vachon didn't get it up and up into the net. Boy, already I see a marked difference, that 1 year age difference between the 13 and the 14s. It's a whole different game here. That'll be out. Emily mentioned in our opening that the number two seed was bestowed on Regina before the tournament. So I wonder if that gives them a little extra confidence going into this championship final. Conversely for Waka, I wonder if they're looking across the net and thinking, oh, this is not gonna be easy.
Absolutely, you know, I think Waka knows they have the ability to knock off some of the top teams in this tournament as they did before. And they're up for the challenge. Like, Waka is always competitive with their women's volleyball teams, and I think they're ready to try to take down this powerful Regina team.
Waka defeated Saskatoon JCVC in the round of 16. They beat Rose Valley in the quarterfinal, and they knocked off the Saskatoon Smash in the semi to get themselves here. That one's out. A little on the long side, so there's a point for Waka. They trail by three, but have the serve. And that's Brooke Metkowski. Rolled it over the net. That's a good break. You need some of those sometimes, I think, in a gold medal game, don't you?
Absolutely, an ace is an ace. It doesn't really matter what it looks like sometimes.
Probably so good you can do that intentionally.
I wish.
Wouldn't that be a serve?
That really would.
That's a little long. Waka scrapping back. Pulling to within a point here, and they will continue to serve. That one's not quite going to get there. Point Regina. They'll send Chloe Loker back to serve. Communication problem there results in a free ball, but Regina doesn't handle it well. Same on their side. A couple times on that rally, we saw people looking up and then looking at each other.
Absolutely. I think at this age level, too, they're just getting used to the flow and style of the game. It's really important to have good communication skills on your side of the net.
Jaden Rudichuk got the top spin going and put it down in the middle of the court. Good serve. Formidable serve. And now let's see if Regina's ready now that they know what's coming. Is it in?
Not quite.
Tiana Eitmeier just stepped back and she was right. Good decision. And a point Regina, 7-6. And there's Eitmeier to serve. Yours. You gotta protect me over here. I'm spending a lot of time looking at my notes, at my rosters. So if the ball's coming this way,
get my hands up.
Save a friend's life, would you?
Will do.
Eitmeier, lots on that serve and a little long. Point for point here, a battle in game number one of this best of three. Dana Vachon, a little firm on it too. Too much adrenaline?
No, a little, probably some nerves running through the system. They're pretty excited to be in the provincial final. They just got to settle in. We'll see which team can settle in first and be successful in this set.
Amara Kohler's serve isn't going to find the court. So the last few serves going astray. This is Cassidy Thibault. Still struggling. All right, Haley Cronville. it's your turn. And it's a little long.
I think these girls really need to focus on going back and taking their time. They've got full 8 seconds to get the ball over the net. Really taking their time after they hear that whistle.
Olivia Jacobson. There we go. Back pass. Trouble there, and it's not going to go. That'll be a point for Regina. Talk about those serves not working. Maybe it's that trying just a little too hard to be too precise. You're in the gold medal game, and you want to make a great play.
Absolutely. You want to make sure you're out there giving it your all, and you're really trying to do your best. But sometimes you just got to step back a little bit, realize that you sometimes play your best when you're not thinking too much at all.
That one's out. Point Waka. Kennedy Alexson. She scored a couple of aces with that serve. There's another.
Uncommon to see a jump float serve at the 14U level, and that's why has the potential to go on some very long runs with this serve.
Tipped in, Brooke Matkowski got it. And here's Waka now, sneaking into the lead, 12-11. And Alexson continues to serve. It is out. I think Haley Craneville decided at the very last second to turn and let it go, and good judge. Donna on the serve now. Just in.
Great defensive efforts in that series. That's the kind of rallies you want to see in the provincial final.
That's good stuff. Brianna Morrison serves again. That one's going to get home. Dana Vachon into the block and then the floor. Tied up at 13, game one in the best of three. This is Brooke Matkowski. Might have been long, but we'll never know. Kristen Galloway decided to play it. Couldn't handle it. There was an ace. Amara Kohlert. Found an opening.
That's a great shot right behind the block. Took a little bit off it, dropped her elbow a little bit, but was able to find the pot open, and that will score lots of the time.
Chloe Loker ready to serve, but the referee is just going to clear some spectators out of the way. You guys to go over there or over there? All right, 14-14. Chloe Loker of Regina's QCBC Royal Elites will serve. Just out. Substitution here now for Waka. Madison Bender and Ashley Gartner, both coming in, I think. Cassidy Thibault is out. And Dana Vachon will come to the bench. Mentioned the short bench, just 9 on the roster for Waka, 12 on the Regina roster, a full set of subs. Another one that catches the tape, but goes. Aiden Rudicek. Good job staying with the free ball there and put it in a hole. That rally looked like it was going to end with something good for Waka, but no. Regina gets it done, and Tiana Eitner set to serve. Little long again. Waka's Madison, or pardon me, Ashley Gartner.
Great serve by Gartner. Yeah. Took a little off it, landed just ahead of the attack line. It's a very efficient serve, the short serve, short to position three. Really makes the passers get on their toes.
On the net, Madison Bender. Gina will serve now, 16-18. Amara Kullert.
Nice shot.
Kennedy Alexson. Girls glancing over, where are we at, where are we at? 19. Keep the pressure on. 3-point lead here in game one.
Nice.
Make
serve.
It four. Right into that back row, and now 4-point lead. Timeout. Regina's QCBC, Don Morrison, calls the timeout. See if they can scrap back here. Make this a little closer.
Right. Some of their serves are topspin, so they drop a little bit sooner. So you have your on your toes ready to come forward and just pass the ball up. Right? And make sure you're deep enough in the court that it's above your shoulders, it's out of bounds. There's been a couple that we've played that have been up high, so we've got to make them pay for the mistakes.
That's Don Morrison. You can see his daughter standing there to the left, and you know that that's his kid because she seems less interested than the rest when her dad talks. I could be wrong, maybe there is no relation. But you've got to think.
I think you're on the right track here.
I have four kids, and I coached. And I know that when I spoke, most of the kids were paying attention, but mine were thinking, oh, here goes dad again. So 20-16 is the score. We'll play to 25 here in game number one. And timeout is over. Waka in the nearest court as you look at it now, wearing white with the advantage here, and they will serve. Madison Bender has the ball at the back line. That's in a good spot. Here's a challenge. The bench tried to clear a path there to allow Chloe Loker to get to it, but not too far gone. And now it's 4 points away from that first game for Waka. Bender. But that top spin that Coach Morrison was talking about.
Nice dig.
Real good job. And another. Waka bringing the defense here now, too. And the block. Everything is working. Regina attacking though, and that'll get it home. Nicely placed there, Haley Craneville. Try and break that momentum here a little bit. It's 21-17, and maybe the serve will help turn the tables a bit for Regina QCBC's Royal Elites. Craneville. They're going to give that one to Regina. And another chance to close it to 2-point gap. Have handled pretty well. Out is the ball. Just what Regina needed. They got the serve. And now a couple points back to back. Cranville again with the serve. And she's found a spot right between two Waka players and right on the line. So after giving up a bundle in a row, quick timeout here called by Lyle Gartner of Waka. What are we doing different, kids?
Just tighten that wrist up a bit. Same serve in the middle of the court after the timeout. Take a pen for their timeout. Keep the ball in play. Remember, on this serve receive, the one player is on the right side, so our middle is going to take that center cut. They're going to power 17, 99.9% of the time. Right? She's going to try to hit corners. She may even try a tip on this one. So let's have our number one come up for tips. See the body early. Six is going to slide. Five is going to drop deep. Four's coming off as well.
Here we go, ladies.
So be prepared. Center dump, and then 17 swing. Royal.
Wow, this is complex stuff these kids are immersed in.
Absolutely. Don Morrison's doing a great job of instructing his team as to what's likely going to happen on the Waka side if they were to get this pass up. He knows that number 17, Kennedy Alexson, is a major offensive threat out there in power now, and he's instructing his middle blocker to be aware of when the ball goes out to power, she knows where to go.
You got all that out of what he said?
I think so. I think I'm on the right track here.
I was hearing Charlie Brown's teaching myself. But Regina scores to tie it up after that pep talk. Let's see if they can keep this little rally going. 5 points in a row now for QCVC's Royal Elite on another. Now they're in an enviable position. 3 points away from this first game, and they've got the serve. Haley Craneville has been standing back there delivering for a long time here. Waka needs to snap it. There's a chance. This is what they wanted. The hit doesn't get there. Kennedy Alexson into the top of the net. What a run.
Absolutely. You see how effective a couple serves in the court in a row can be. Change the momentum of the game.
Ooh, there's a good serve, too. A lot of power. Free ball. And they got it. Back to the attack. And it's in. Wow. Looked like Waka was cruising in game one. And look at this run from Regina. And now a chance to finish it off. But Lyle Gartner is going to shut this down for a second. That's the Waka coach calling a timeout.
Play defense. Let's go. Hey, get one ball down here. You never know what happens here. But let's go. Hey, a lot of faces here. No reason.
Trying to motivate there a little bit with a little bit of, hey, come on.
Absolutely.
Shake it off.
It looks like they just need a bit of a kick in the pants almost to get going here.
Set it over off speed. She might be tipping cross court.
Be right behind the block.
Amara, you got tipped on the line. Right, 16 feet. Lots of body. Let's take the ball.
Interesting.
Have fun out there. Roll.
Meanwhile, Todd Morrison, they don't have to coach energy right now. He can stand there and deliver some technical and try and finish off this first game.
Absolutely.
Cranville serving for game one. It's a best of three for the gold medal and the 14U. Off the tape, and there it is. Game one goes to Regina. Terrific comeback. Wow.
That's some great serving by Cranville down the stretch there.
8 points reeled off of that serve. And they'll take game one. Hang on, game two coming up. You're watching the Conexus Provincial Volleyball Championships on Shaw. on the sidelines here, just awaiting the huddle of the QCVC Royal Elite. And there's Don Morrison with last words. How about that comeback in the first game?
Absolutely. You know, you really saw the team who began to serve well take over the match. And I thought QCVC did a great job showing lots of maturity, not getting too flustered when they were down against Waka, but they came back and they were able to chip away and ultimately win that set.
That was a terrific comeback. And now the question I have is, can Waka bounce back, take some momentum, and stop leading, as it were, here in the start of game two?
Absolutely. I definitely think Waka can. They're not the type of team to just sort of roll over and die. I think they're looking to serve more aggressively and really improve their passing game to stay in system more, and they're trying to get the ball, I bet, to number 17 Kennedy Leskin a bit more, as she wasn't super involved in that first set.
The teams have broken their huddle. Just checking the lineups here. Make sure that they've got everybody on the court where they said they were going to put them on the court. Get that straightened out. Jamie Kalenich will be in the game. Sounds like Coach pulled the old typo. It's all good. And with that sorted out, the ball goes to Kennedy Alexson to serve to start game number two again. We'll play up to 25. Waka's got to win this one to force a third game. Little long. Good jump, Ashley Gartner. Just hit it long. Let go off the block.
I don't think so, but you could tell she was really looking for hands when she did go up for that swing. She just didn't quite find them. There were two sets of hands in front of her.
You know what? She did. Yeah, they called
it
off the block.
My bad.
It was a late call.
And an ace by Alexa.
So this is the start the Warriors needed, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Got the break by getting a little bit of the block on that first hit. That's a good serve, too. Oh, boy. Well done.
Great one-arm dig there.
Nice. Short pass. This is a great rally going here. And Regina gets themselves on the scoreboard.
Absolutely. Melnick does a really good job of getting up and keeping her elbow high, swinging off the hands of the middle blocker for Waka, resulting in a tool shot. Great kill for her.
Amanda Melnick will serve. Put that in a good spot, and look at the fracas she created over there for Waka. So a chance to attack. Presta got it there, and it doesn't make it back. Point for Regina. Melnick again. Got it. Off the block. What do we got?
Yep. Caught a piece of it. That's a great shot. The turning in the air, almost a bit of a cross body finish. That's a nice roll shot.
Pretty athletic pull.
Absolutely.
And another point for Regina. So they give Waka that good start, but then quickly bounce back and take three in a row. And here they come again. Chance to set it up. Oh, nice job. All the offense coming from Regina, and then they put up the defense there too and turn it away as Abigail Ziaba made the key block there. And another point for Regina.
No.
Good block that time. Wow. But a nice recovery as well by Ziova. She'll hit again. That one had something on it. It's gone. 5-point roll here for Regina. The QCBC Royal Elite. Playing pretty mean right now. Melnick is going to serve again.
Absolutely. Ziova's playing very fearlessly out in that left side for QCBC. She's swinging away and getting lots of good contacts.
This is trouble. And now that run is 6 points. And that qualify as momentum.
Absolutely.
No doubt about it. Waka is on their heels, and if they get another point scored against them, it wouldn't be surprised if Gartner shuts it down for a minute to try and build something on the bench. What happened there?
I believe they're calling a carry. Yeah, yep. A bit of a lift actually on that contact.
There is the 7th point on this run. Melnick still serving. Battle at the net. I'm going to give this one to Regina. Timeout called now by Lyle Gartner. It took him until 8 were reeled off by the QCBC Royal Elite to finally pull the kids in and see if he can turn this thing around.
Hitting the ball, but we gotta get the first pass up. Okay? Okay, let's go.
Lyle's always pretty quick to the point.
Absolutely.
We're not doing this well. You got to do it.
For sure. You know, it's just more of a mental break for the players. You know, you want to communicate the right amount of information, but you don't want to overwhelm your players. And that's sometimes all you need is a quick break and then getting back onto the court, feeling a little bit refreshed, ready to pass the ball here.
A noticeably louder break from the huddle on the Regina side, where they have rattled off a streak of 8 consecutive points. They won the first game 25-21. And Amanda Melnick still serving. Yeah. That was, as serves go, you know, you leave it because you think it might be out. You're right. As that sort of thing goes, that was a big one, because if they were wrong,
that would
have stuck.
Been good. Yeah,
but
absolutely.
Maybe this is what it takes for Waka to get that serve back now, make a good judgment on that long serve, turn it into something. Yeah, not gonna work.
One thing QCBC is doing very well is staying in the system. They're getting awesome passes off the serve receive balls, and they can run their middle and really establish the different zones of the net. They're doing a very good job of that.
Sanskriti Shrestha finished off that point. And it's 9-3. A lot of free balls being played here by Waka. There's some contact on the net. Waka will take it, 9-4. And Jaden Rudichuk serving for Waka. I think she really liked the toss that she got for the service.
Tough toss.
Kind of ended up backing off as she swung her arm.
The toss is a very important part of the serve. When your toss is off, you're probably not going to get a very good contact.
Can you just let it drop?
I don't believe so. You'd have to check the rule book on that
one. Nice job, Jamie Kalenich.
Kalenich doing a really good job of using all of those hands. There's a lot of hands in front of her there. Waka was putting up a triple block in their middle, but she was able to find the seams.
And Tresta will serve with a pretty handsome lead here right now. Last game, we saw Regina battle back from being down 4 or 5 points. Let's see if Waka's got that moxie. They'll take the long serve for one. 5, serves 11. Ashley Gartner. Nice job on the block there. It was Kayla Burnick and Madison Bender. Absolutely. Up for Waka.
And blocks are sometimes a huge momentum changer. We'll look to see if that really energizes this Waka team. And an ace, wow.
What they need?
Absolutely.
Couple back-to-back. Can change a lot. Ashley Gartner will serve again. 7-11. Ooh! Missed it by that much.
Much. Unfortunately, it was called a ball handling error on the play, but.
Abigail Ziaba. That one.
Good heads up play by Ziaba. Seeing that ball coming over and deciding to get up and attack it back instead of stepping off the net and setting the ball.
Back it'll come to Amanda. Abigail, rather, for the serve.
Three ball, ladies, three ball.
Nice ball.
Oh boy. Jaden Rudichuk had a long time with that free ball, and you could see her take a little peek as the ball was coming down and she hit her spot.
Absolutely.
Well done.
That's a great place to put a standing down ball back into position one on QCVC's side of the court. Very tough to defend against.
That'll be long. Waka gave up a string of 8 points in a row, but since then, kind of been two for one-ing here and sneaking back into it. That'll be long. And Regina sees their lead dwindle now down to just three. Madison Bender on the serve for Waka. Might have been long, we'll never know. Good effort there from Rudichuk, but QCVC's Royal Elite pick up their 14th point. 1-0, Regina leading the best of three, and here they are serving at 14-10. Madison, here we go. Zolik for Regina. Practice the names before, sometimes it doesn't matter. Spin it alive. Good pass.
Great swing.
Oh boy.
Great dig as well.
Good effort there by Piper and Heckrell, but ended up handling the ball, and it'll be a point. Waka. It was a nice little rally to watch.
Absolutely. Great swing from the left side of Waka and an equally awesome dig from QCVC.
Here we go. Ladies, pass up. Here we go. Get it right back.
11-14. Michaela Bariniak.
Here we go, ladies. Pass up.
Curve, just making sure everything is right in the rotation here. All good. Here comes Bariniak's serve. Short. Kind of at 15 points. Walker's going to make a sub. Bariniak comes off. Oh, wait a second. Yep. It's Olivia Jacobson.
6 going in. No, 12 going in. 6.
You got that? Everybody got it? We got it.
I think we're ready to go again here.
Jacobson is in. Almost came in a point too early there, but they got it all done. Jamie Kalinich's serve is a good one. Out it goes. 16-11, sneaking closer and closer to the gold medal. One loss in this tournament for Regina's QCBC Royal Elite. They lost to the Saskatoon Huskies Green. Waka comes into this undefeated.
Great serve.
Oh, just over the net with something on it. And nobody can handle it on the Waka side. Another sub. Dana Vachon coming in the game as Jaden Rudichuk will go out for the Warriors. Kalinich at 17-11, ready to serve. That one's long. The 2015 Conexus Provincial Volleyball Championships. Want to thank the title sponsor, Conexus Credit Union, for their generous support of volleyball in Saskatchewan. 17-12 is the score. Regina in the lead and a timeout.
There hasn't been a smile, there hasn't been anything. You know what? We're not out of this game. But by the looks of six faces here, or nine faces, we're out. Okay? I mean, hey, we're down. What are we down? A couple points. Hey, let's get going. Be aggressive hitting the ball. We haven't been aggressive this whole game. We've given three balls back, and they've hit the ball better than we have. That's as simple as that. Okay? They've got 9 points. They've got 8 points to get here. You just don't give up on it. Okay? Who's up here right now? Okay, this is where it's at.
You guys should have lots of confidence. No nerves out there. Just stay positive and have fun. All right? We'll work for a point. 8 points, and we'll see what happens. Here we go.
One of those coaches is in a much easier position right now, isn't he?
Absolutely. It's much easier to motivate your athletes when you are winning. It's not as easy when you're down by a few. What the hell? It ultimately comes down to the decision the athletes make on the court, if they're ready to fight back or if they're, and I'm sure at this level, they're not ready to just roll over and let QCBC take this one.
Kennedy Alexan is serving. 12 serving 17. That's going to help. Nice hard serve there as Shretzla played it, but didn't get a real clean play on it. Nobody was able to get there in time to support. So it's 13-17. And here's Alexan again. Jamie Kalinich signals crossed with Madison Lozek.
Very uncharacteristic of QCBC. We've seen them communicating very well so far.
That serve. A beauty. Is there a rule of thumb when the ball is in a hole like that, if players are face-to-face, there's really no right or wrong. It's just somebody's got to take charge.
There's not, it? Absolutely. Yeah, there's got to be a lot of communication happening on the serve receive, especially with the jump serve. The ball is really moving around, coming off of the server's hand. You've got to be lots of talk about who's taking what seam to the right or left of each other, and there just needs to be lots more happening for QCBC's side.
This is not,
yeah,
sit there and pop a ball outside. There's nobody wanting to take that ball. That's right. Just time out, see if you get a little bit off of her serve. Stop, be on your toes. You've got a nice high ceiling here, so square up. Stay low, pass it up high. You've been swinging very well. Look at all the balls that are off the net for the first pass. So they're doing a great job. Get them out there, middle of power.
Sorry.
Push it out of power so you're ready to get up there and swing.
Well, the good news for Waka. They've closed the gap. And Alexan is still serving. She's been dynamite. Giving the Royal Elite all they can handle with her jump serves. Another. They're gonna like that one. And it's good. Sanskriti Shretzta down the line. And now they've got the serve back. Amanda Melnick at 18-15 now. great serve herself. That's going to be double played as it came into Brooke Matkowski. Make it 19-15.
We've definitely seen the servers get better as this game has progressed. They're getting more comfortable, a little more looser, and they're really able to rip on the ball now.
They are. They're putting them over the net with some velocity in there.
Absolutely.
They're not going long anymore. Trouble there for Madison Bender. Cut through her hands, and it's 20-15. Look at the scoreboard, and you see 20. That's a nice boost. You know you're close.
Absolutely. You can start to taste it.
Missed that by a fraction. So it's 16-20. This is Brooke Matkowski. Big chance for her. Well done. Now out of the attack. We're going to have to just get that over. This one is set up a little better.
Set.
Tight, Abby.
Yes! Got it!
That's a great heads-up play by Zioba. Seeing the ball is tight and then going up, but also staying clean, really tightening up as she goes over the net and penetrates, but is able to stay clean and get that point for her team. That's an awesome play.
And Piper Peckroll ready to serve now for Regina. That one's into the net, though. Get a point, and then they give it back. Waka clinging to life, and they're getting their chances here. Dana Vachon. Nice serve. That one is into the net off Shrestha. 21-18. Energy is back on that Warriors side of the net. Big point there. 22-18 instead of 21-19. Shrestha. Off the block.
Great dig.
Alive. Did she find a spot? Nope. Melnick went a little long. Waka will serve again. Ashley Gardner.
Two contacts is the call there. You can really tell when the ball doesn't come cleanly off and there's lots of spin off the set. That's usually when two contacts will be called.
23-19 and Ziava serving. 24. One more for Regina. One more for the gold medal. And Waka can't answer. QCDC Royal Elite 2015 Kinexus Provincial Volleyball Champions in the 14U division. Number 2 seed coming in, Waka, a surprise finalist to some. Battled hard. Kept it close all along, but it ends up 25-21 and 25-19. The Regina QCBC Royal Elite are provincial champions.
Just a great game played by QCBC. They were steady throughout. They never had too many ups or too many downs. They were very steady, played a very solid game, and they really deserve this win. Good team win for the girls.
Sure was. We hope you enjoyed it, everybody. It was a pleasure being at the Hank Reese Soccer Center to bring you the action live. And we want to thank again Kinexus Credit Union for being part of Volleyball in Saskatchewan and allowing us to be here today to bring it to you. I'm Pete Mulligan on behalf of Emily Humbert and our entire Shaw team. Farewell for now.